Hello everyone, my name is Marius Pachitariu, and I will describe the stringer datasets of 10,000 neuron recordings that you will use in the Neuromatch Academy. These datasets are part of a recent trend in neuroscience to increase the number of neurons we can record simultaneously. As you can see, this trend wildly exceeds even the most optimistic expectations of Conrad and Ian Stevenson from 2010. Many labs can in fact now record neural activity from almost an entire cortical column, which is defined as approximately a 1 by 1 by 1 millimeter chunk of brain. The main technologies allowing this are calcium imaging and neuropixels probes. Here I am describing the calcium imaging data. The nice thing about calcium imaging is that I can just show you the data as a video. The field of view in this case is about 1 by 1 millimeter horizontally, and you can see multiple planes corresponding to different depths of imaging, from very superficial in layers 2-3 all the way to the top of layer 5, about 500 microns below the brain surface. This data is from a mouse that is head fixed on an air floating ball. The brain area we're recording from is visual cortex, but the recordings are done in complete darkness, meaning there is no sensory input arriving to the visual cortex. The mouse is performing what we call spontaneous behaviors, such as locomotion, whisking, sniffing, and grooming behaviors. The dataset for the projects includes several quantifications of these behaviors. In the paper, we do several analyses on this data, as well as on NeuroPixels data, and you can find all datasets online on Figshare. For the project, we will only consider one of the calcium imaging datasets, which has been binned temporally at approximately 1 hertz. The videos I showed on the previous slide have been automatically processed to extract the time courses of activity in the cells that we recorded. Here are some example regions of interest that have been automatically detected by a framework called C2P to give you a sense of what the neurons look like. The recording has about 10,000 of these. This dataset is ideally suited for applying all sorts of structure discovery algorithms, from clustering to dimensionality reduction to dynamical modeling. In the paper, we used a simple but powerful visualization that we call a raster map, shown here on the right. Raster map is obtained by arranging the activity patterns of the neurons along the y-axis of an image plot, so that neurons with similar activity patterns are next to each other. This gives rise to clear clusters of activity, as well as gradients from the top to the bottom of this activity map. We were very intrigued by these patterns of activity in visual cortex because, remember, the mice are in complete darkness, so that no sensory input whatsoever is arriving to these neurons. This structured discovery approach led us to consider the mouse's spontaneous behaviors, which seemed like a good candidate for explaining the patterns of neural activity. We quantified these patterns using a principal components analysis of the motion energy of the mouse face movies, and used the behavioral traces in turn to predict neural activity directly. And here on the bottom, you can see our prediction. We found that indeed a lot of the neural activity could be predicted this way, which you can read more about in the paper. This shows that the structure discovery approach is powerful, and we're absolutely convinced there is a lot more interesting information hidden in these data sets. We're also including a separate data set of neural responses to visual stimuli, in this case, oriented gratings, defined by a single stimulus parameter, the orientation of the grating. The mice are not doing a task with these stimuli. They're just running on the air floating ball and just doing mouse things while we record even more neurons, in this case, about 20,000. You can see the neurons into this, another one of these raster map style images, which we now sorted along the y-axis according to the preferred stimulus of each neuron. You can see on each stimulus presentation, there is a bump of neural activity in the neurons that preferred that particular stimulus. There are a lot of stimuli shown, about 5,000, spanning the range from 0 to 360 degrees, and sampled randomly. If we zoom in on a narrow range of stimuli, we can see some typical responses from a neuron. Even though overall this neuron prefers this particular stimulus value, you can see it fails to activate on many trials. This is a very general neuroscience phenomenon that people refer to as trial-to-trial variability. Even though single neurons are variable like that and noisy, the population as a whole actually encodes the stimulus very precisely. You can use your favorite decoding approach to show this, as we did in the paper, to get decoding accuracies of the stimulus on the order of 1 degree of error or even less. You can go to the full paper to learn more, or you can start exploring the dataset on your own.